Let's explore this job order costing problem. Now, there's lots of information on the screen. I'm going to point to some items. Okay, we've got labor costs, material costs, and some other costs. So all in this area here, everywhere where I'm sort of pointing to with the mouse, relates to actual costs. Okay, then down below, we get a little bit of background. So let me read that to you. It says the firm's job order costing system uses direct labor hours measured at practical capacity as the cost driver for overhead application in December, Then it says in December of the preceding year, Char, that's the accountant, she had prepared the following budget for direct labor and manufacturing overhead costs for the current year. The plant is theoretically capable of operating at 150,000 direct labor hours per year, but she estimates that practical capacity is 120,000 hours in the year. So here's what she came up with. She said on a predetermined basis, or her projections or her forecast, call it whatever you like, she said at 100,000 direct labor hours, variable cost will be 325,000, fixed cost will be 216,000. Again, this is just their manufacturing overhead. And then we see the variable costs go up at 120,000 direct labor hours, and they would go up if the plant operates at 140,000 direct labor hours. Fixed costs are fixed, of course, so they're not going to change with regard to the level of activity at which the plant operates. And then they also tell us that during November, the following jobs were completed, job 77 and job 78. Okay, now I've rearranged the screen so that we've got room to address the first question. And the first question says, determine the predetermined overhead rate. All right, so let me show you how we would go about that. All right, there's the formula right there. With the predetermined overhead rate, you take budgeted manufacturing overhead and you divide it by whatever the activity base is. And in our case, it's the budgeted direct labor hours. So in other words, you use predetermined what you think you're going to spend and divide it by the actual activity hours that relate to what you think you're going to spend. Now, let's go through the math here. The answer turns out to be 507, but how did we come up with it? Okay. So now you can see we took the 392,400 of variable overhead and added the 216,000. So the 392, just to the left of my mouse, relates to the 120,000 of direct labor hours. Now, why are we using that? Well, they told us that the job order costing system uses direct labor hours measured at practical capacity. Practical capacity is really, in my view, the theoretical correct approach to use because it winds up capturing in your inventory costs or your, overhead applied costs, the correct amount of fixed manufacturing overhead. If you use a lower amount, such as what actual capacity might be planned or a theoretical capacity, you get a different value of fixed overhead rather than practical capacity. And in my opinion, practical capacity is the most accurate way to measure inventory costs. So using the 120,000, which represents practical capacity, we add the variable and fixed cost together. That's our numerator, 608,400, and we divide it by the activity level, which is the 120,000 of direct labor hours. So predetermined overhead rate is $5.07 per direct labor hour. Okay, now I've rearranged the screen again so that now we have the actual results that we covered earlier on the top of the screen. And what we're going to do now is calculate the cost of job 77. Okay, so to calculate the total cost of job 77, we're going to start off with what was in beginning inventory. It was 52,000, right here they told us. Beginning work in process inventory, all job 77 was 52,000. Then we've got to add in the direct labor costs and the direct material and the overhead. Normally the order is material, labor, overhead. So let's start off with the material. Right there they tell us 45,000, this is the left of my mouse here, was direct material and supplies requisitioned for production to job 77. So we're going to add in that 45,000. Then we're going to add in direct labor. All right, how do we come up with direct labor? Well, they tell us there was 3,500 hours, and they told us what the direct labor wages were. So if we take the $221,000 and divide it by all the direct labor hours earned, we're going to come up with that $26. So that would be $221,000 divided by, it looks like, $8,500. Okay, if I slide down, I think we'll see the calculation here. Yeah, right there, 221 divided by 8,500 is the $26. So that's where that $26 right there to the left of my mouse comes out to. So 3,500 times 26, that's our 91,000. And then, of course, we have to apply the overhead, which was the 35 hours, right? They gave us the direct labor hours, times the $5.07 predetermined overhead rate that we calculated earlier. So we multiply the hours times the applied manufacturing overhead rate, add that all up, and we can determine what the cost of job 77 was. And there it is, $205,745. Okay, now I've repositioned the screen again so that we can tackle the last part of this job order costing exercise. We're going to now determine the actual manufacturing overhead incurred during the month. Okay, so at this point, what we're focused on is manufacturing overhead spending. It's typically called spending. Rather than focusing on what was the cost per unit or what was the overhead applied, we're going to focus on what was total overhead spending, or what was the total manufacturing overhead incurred during the month. So here all we're going to do is take a look at the information that was provided and identify which one of these represents overhead. Okay, well, there was indirect materials of $12,000. Okay, right there to the left of my mouse, it told us that there were supplies as indirect materials, not direct materials. Okay, and then there was indirect labor wages, $17,000. They gave that to us in dollars. And there was supervisory salaries, $6,500, here just to the left of my mouse. They gave that to us. And then there was building occupancy cost and factory rent, factory facility, $6,600. That's there. Okay, now we then jump to production equipment costs, and that's $8,100, the entire amount, because all of this relates to production. We ignore the sales office and the administrative offices because those costs don't relate to manufacturing in any way. Those are operating expenses. Okay, so when we're done, we're able to calculate what the actual manufacturing overhead incurred was, which is also sometimes called what was the actual manufacturing overhead spending. All right, and that's this problem, everyone. Thank you.